Today I'm going to talk about the seismic behavior of the Marga-Marga Bridge and the seismic protection device. But why I choose the Marga-Marga Bridge? Because it was the first bridge with the seismic protection in Chile. So it's a very interesting case to expose you. We must do in the beginning. Insulation. Insulation, I think someone will talk about this, but this is only a review. It called the insulation with lead core. It doesn't have a lead, but it means had a rubber and a steel plate, but it's called lead core. The function is the initial steam, keeps the initial stiffness, and the damping reach the 30%, increase the 30%. The Marga-Marga Bridge characteristic, in a brief review, was built in 1996. It was the first seismic system. It's located in Viña del Mar, in the Marga-Marga Creek. And he had the 24 accelerometer network. And this is important because this is accelerometers will be take all the information of the 27 February earthquake. And he has 383 meters. The technical characteristic, he have the eight piers between 23 and 21 meters. The varies the length. The deck is a reinforced concrete slab with six steel beams. In the bottom of the slab, and it has the triaxial accelerometers. Triaxial, it takes the three movements of the earthquake. And this is important. It was modeled by infinite elements that we will see the result later. There was the frequencies of the earthquake of the 27, the earthquake of February 27, and we can see the fundamental frequency. It was 0.85 hertz, and the smaller frequency, it was 0.42 hertz. It's a little bit higher, no? And the damping was 19% increase. And as we can see, the damping increase with the seismic demand, with the accelerations. And here we see the finite elements model, the characteristic of the model. He has 683 nodes. It has 1,100 elements, and the weight is 11,500 tons. The pierces were considered fixed in the base, fijos, and the insulation are presented by nonlinear elements. Is the result? There are good news to the longitudinal direction because there are good relation in the longitudinal direction. That there are good relation between the theoretical and experimental displacement, but are bad news to the to the transversal direction, because the mud is not able to reproduce the predominant frequency. I mean the higher and smaller frequencies. This is all. Thanks very much.